Hey guys, and you're back with IDED of IDEDOnline. And today, for this Tablet Gaming Tuesday, we're going to take a look at Fallout Shelter, the sibling of the new Fallout 4 game impending for release next month. So, what is Fallout Shelter? Well, Fallout Shelter is what most would call a strategy game. It's all about, how do we put it, like sort of sim management, so to speak. You're going to be looking after your vault dwellers. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new vault, just to give you a quick show of what the start of the game is like. And what we'll do is we're actually going to call this one Vault 404, not found. Alright, as you can see, it has some very funky, sort of very classical Fallout 4 loading sequences. It's got the nice little flicker between the video catches, all those sort of bits and pieces, all included in classic Fallout fashion. And basically, the whole game revolves around the classic Pip-Boy figure, which I think is one of the main attractive points of the game for me. It's what drew me to play it. Now, it is a freemium title. Now, I know this word obviously scares the bejeebers out of a lot of people out there, because freemium means generally they're going to charge you through the to play. It's just the way it goes. But Fallout's not too bad for it. Everything that can be purchased can also just be earned by playing the game itself. So if you're willing to put the time in, you can still achieve these things. Okay, so as you start, you're going to get all these sort of bits and pieces, all these hints, and it's going to tell you to build, of course, your power generator. Now, general just piece of advice for you when making your vault, you always want to make the rooms the free wide versions. Generally, that rule applies to everything. Alright, so we're going to tap on this dweller to see his information, and you've got the special stat, each one standing for its own characteristics. So you've got strength, perception, endurance, charisma, intelligence, agility, and luck. Now, each one of these has its own room and things that it's relevant for, except for luck. Luck is just literally how lucky that person is. Alright, so what we'll do is we'll drag this person in, and we're going to set them into our generator room. So he's going to get moved inside as the vault opens to allow him in. And we're also going to check our second dweller in there as well. There we go. And that gives us access to two people working our power plant. Now, as the people work within any sort of the areas of your vault, they will automatically gain experience as well as generating one of three stats. Now, these three stats, as you'll see at the top of the screen here, are electricity, food, and water. And you can zoom in on any of the rooms, as it's just shown you there by double tapping. It's really cool as well, because you get the sort of 3D thing, which is quite funky. Obviously, there's this rushes here, which takes a potential risk of failure. If it fails, you can end up with a fire in that room, you can end up with a mole rat invasion, or any of the similar bits and pieces. Anyway, let's go in. It wants us to build a diner. So what we're going to do is we're going to build the diner underneath, mainly because I want to extend the power. And they want us to build a water treatment plant. I'm going to build the water treatment plant here, but I would naturally remove that later, because each row hasn't got enough space on it for you to build three sets of 3x3 rooms. You can build 2 3x3 rooms, and then you can have one by two room at the end. So you've only got enough space for 2 sort of 3 wide rooms and 1 2 wide room in each row. Alright, so now we've got a queue of little dwellers, all wanting to come in. As you can see, all of them, their stats are pretty low. By assigning people to the correct room, you can actually get a lot better sort of production. But for now, we're just going to put all of these into our vault. So we'll check them in. Some of them in there. And you'll notice when they actually come into your vault, which is reasonably upsetting, is that they actually lose the outfit they're wearing when they're outside. So if they're wearing a cool outfit, don't get your hopes up, because you're just going to lose it. Especially some of the outfits as well, because you'll recognise them. They'll be, I think that the next guy I'm just dragging in now is wearing a handyman outfit, which gives +3 to your agility. Which would be a really nice outfit to have on hand, but unfortunately, no. There you go, and you can see we've got an achievement there. So this is how basically how it starts out. You're going to have a very active play time. The same as starting out in like The Simpsons Tapped Out or similar. You're going to be very quickly paced about your first sort of half an hour of playtime. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you some of the other bits. So basically, going into here, you can see all the rooms unlock by gaining more dwellers. So the more dwellers you have in your vault, the more rooms you have available to you. The maximum room being 100, and that's the Nuka-Cola bottler. And as you can see up there, it requires 100 dwellers in your vault for you to have access to that. Now, there's also some other bits and pieces. In here, this is where you would purchase and unlock items like the Mr. Handy, who will go around collecting coins for you, and you can send him out into the bits, or he'll just collect the rooms when they're ready. You can also get these lunch boxes, which can contain cards. Basically, each one has four cards and at least one rare or better, as you can see there, and you can get specialist dwellers from that. You can also get specialist items, weapons, clothing, etc. So that's what you've got there, and here, if you have any, you can unlock them, and I'll show you that in a second. You also have your inventory, and you have a maximum amount of any of these items you can carry. So you can see by standard you have 10 spaces. So that means 10 spaces for guns and 10 spaces for outfits for your guys to collect. You can get these by sending your dwellers into the wasteland. So let's get this dweller here, just to give you an example of how that's done. We'll select him, if it'll let us. And we drag him out here like that. And then it'll give us the option to send him exploring. Now, to anyone who wants to send anyone exploring, you want to look to have realistically the perception and the endurance stat quite high for them to survive in the Outlands by themselves. So remember that. And you can also set them to carry either the Stimpaks, which will give them extra health, and the Radaways. Now, myself, I found that these really don't seem to help. I've assigned most of my dwellers who go out with like sort of three or five of these, and they never seem to use them. They just seem to die anyway without using any of them. So I don't know how to activate these myself. Someone may be able to put in the comments the correct way to do that without having any issues. Basically, you'd have this. You can sign them obviously with their outfits in here and a gun in here, which you want to make sure they have at least but one of each of those. And then you'd click explore, and that will send them off into the wilderness, and they will go hunting down credits and items, and they will gain loads of XP by killing loads of the creatures out there. So that's one of the benefits you can get from doing that. And obviously you have to destroy rocks and other bits and pieces like that as we go down through the earth here. Now you've obviously got a list of like the items you've collected basically, and there is a help section available to you as well. Most of that is basically what I've covered already in this video. There's also some settings, etc., so you can adjust bits and pieces of how it sounds, how it looks, etc., if you want notifications outside of the game, and if you want to have screenshots taken and stuff like that. You know, beyond that, this game, realistically, I wouldn't throw money away on this game. It's a good game, don't get me wrong, it's fun to play, but everything can be earned by playing it. If you're going to play it, play it. Don't bother like wasting money on something that you can get for free if you're just going to play the actual game. And the game is this. See here, we've got successfully rushed one room, and that'll give us one chest. So one of the lunch boxes. So what we'll do is, I'll tell you what, we'll rush this room. And see, if we successfully rush this room, hopefully, there we go, we achieve this goal. By achieving this goal, we get one of the items you'd normally pay for, which is a lunchbox. We'll go into here, and we'll drag our lunchbox in, and let's see what we get for our new vault. So we've got, boom, a Stimpak, yay. A handyman jumpsuit, agility plus 3, which is great when you're starting out. 100 caps, can't be complained at, to help to build towards rooms. And a specialist weapon, 4-8. An armor-piercing lever-action rifle. That's not a bad item. It's not one of the best. There are a lot better weapons than this. The flamers and obviously some of the laser pistols, etc., are a lot harder, as it is with the real game. But still, it's a good item to have. And then you could go around assigning these to any dweller you want by just clicking on them. And we could go, this guy here, we'll give him a gun. This person who works in our cafeteria will have the agility plus 3 because it makes him produce better. And that's how that works, basically. But if we... what we're going to do here is I'm going to go back up to the main menu, and I'm going to show you a vault I've made earlier. To quote the classic line, here is one I made earlier. And this one is going to just show you what the game will look like once you've got to almost the completed level, as I've played quite a bit. And this is why I'm saying I wouldn't waste your money on it. I've put my effort in here. So if we go to our vault list, and we'll go to vault 101, and we'll load that vault. Okay, and here you can see this is my finished vault. It's a little bit sort of laggy when it first loads in as it turns on the power in the room. And this is what my massive vault looks like. This is what the stats markers will look like when they've achieved a level up. So you can click on these actually give you money as well as the item. Obviously the character leveling up in the trained ability. Go through, click on all this sort of stuff, we'll get all our bits and pieces. Those. This is what the Radio Shack room looks like when it's got a person, so if we click that, that'll bring a brand new dweller into our vault. Of course you can breed your dwellers as well, and by putting, basically you want to put two of the similar stat in there together to obviously generate an offspring with a higher form of that stat. Generally you have to just make sure they're not in the same family line. That can be detected quite easily by when you put them into the room together. Double click on the room, it will zoom in on it, and that will show you then what they're talking about. And if they're talking about spending time with their family, then you obviously know they're basically siblings of some sort or from some same family line, and then thusly you're not going to get anything from them by putting them in the room. Basically you're going to have to need to swap over their partner for someone who's not part of their family line. Now the one I just collected there is the Nuka-Cola bottler. This is a free-wide Nuka-Cola bottling plant, and this generates for you food and water. It's not just one. It's quite an intensive drain on your electric, but well worth it once you've got obviously the nuclear reactor and the upgraded versions of those. But generally, yeah, once you've got to this sort of stage, there's not really much going on. You're going to have to put up with deathcore and radar attacks all the time, but those don't really become that much of an issue as you progress further into the game. They're just a nuisance. There's no real end game, which I think was the only disappointment for me, as far as it goes with it being a Fallout title. It's a fun game. It's really entertaining. Building up your massive vault full of all these sort of crazy little pit boys and all the different outfits is a great idea, great concept. Hopefully they'll bring in something to sort of bring it to a close at some point. But for now, it is what it seems to be. So if you enjoy sort of simulation games and like sort of micromanagement games, this is most probably a title for you. Obviously, anyone who's a fan of Fallout is going to really enjoy this title too. So I definitely recommend it for you guys out there. It's a really sort of interesting title. But unfortunately, yeah, I wouldn't put any money down on it if I was you. It's just not worth the hassle, because everything can be attained for nothing, pretty much. And you know, you can get quite extensive collections of items and outfits, etc., without having to do anything other than send your dwellers out. So all you've got to do is collect a nice sort of amount of dwellers with good stats, basically good perception, endurance, as I mentioned earlier, for sort of exploring, and just send them out into the wild, and they'll collect you no end of caps and no end of gear anyway, which you can get rare items in that as well. So that's pretty much it for this tablet gaming Tuesday. This is Fallout Shelter. There are links to download this are obviously available for you below. It's a great game, worth a try. I definitely recommend it. Obviously post comments below to let me know what your opinions of this game are, if you agree or disagree with me on this. But still, nonetheless, this is IDED, signing off until next time. So till then, look after yourselves.